Hello everyone, this is Sean with the National Weather Service in Billings. In this short presentation, I will discuss how to interpret precipitation estimate data generated by a Doppler weather radar. One of the Doppler radar precipitation estimate products available for viewing on National Weather Service websites is called the 1-hour precipitation product. Using a series of algorithms, the radar estimates the amount of precipitation that has fallen within the hour leading up to when the product is generated. In this example, from August 9, 2013, generally light rainfall accumulated across portions of south-central Montana and north-central Wyoming from 3:11 p.m. to 4:11 p.m., but there are pockets of over an inch of rainfall estimated near Hardin and Billings. We know this because the legend on the right shows that the radar measures precipitation in inches, abbreviated INS. When used with other hydrometeorological products and knowledge of local terrain, the 1-hour precipitation product can help meteorologists hone in on areas that may be prone to flash flooding. Storm total precipitation is another Doppler weather radar precipitation product available on National Weather Service websites. Precipitation amounts are estimated similarly to the 1-hour precipitation product, except the storm total precipitation product shows the estimate of total precipitation from the time a disturbance or storm began to impact a region. This could be over a few hours or several days. In this example, from August 9, 2013, we can see several pockets where the radar estimated over an inch of rain accumulated during various periods between 11:08 a.m. and 4:11 p.m. By using the storm total precipitation product in conjunction with other products, meteorologists can pinpoint areas that have the potential for a longer duration flooding event. We hope these lessons on Doppler weather radar were informative. Remember, radar data on our website can be accessed by clicking on the radar image towards the bottom of the main page. Please join me in the near future for a series of lessons on weather satellites and their uses.